Hello everyone, I am Vivek Nahadia. I am a chartered accountant in practice. I am partner in Hari Agarwal and Associates Chartered Accountants Hyderabad. My topic for today's deliberation is
sales return under GST. If the goods are returned by the customer, the following actions are required at supplier's end. The supplier has sold the goods to the customer, but the customer has returned all or part of the goods to the supplier. So what actions are required to be done by the supplier? First point, the supplier has to issue a credit note with the prescribed particulars. These particulars I have discussed at the end. Details of such credit note must be mentioned in the return for the month when such credit note has been issued. The month when you are issuing the credit note, suppose you are issuing the credit note in the month of August, then in August's return, you'll have to mention the details of this credit note. Credit note cannot be issued later than September following the end of the financial year in which such supply was made, or the date of furnishing of the relevant annual return, whichever is earlier. Let us discuss this with a simple example. Suppose you have sold the goods in the financial year 17-18. That is, in the financial year 1st April 2017 to 31st March 2018. For this financial year, you can issue the credit note maximum by earlier of September 2018, that is 30th September 2018, or the date of filing of annual return. The date of filing of annual return. So for financial year 17-18, your due date of filing the annual return would be 31st December 2018. So if you are filing the annual return before 30th September 2018, suppose you are filing the annual return on 31st August 2018, then earlier of these two dates would be 31st August 2018. So maximum by 31st August 2018, you will have to issue the credit note. If you are not filing the annual return before 30th September 2018, then suppose you are filing the annual return on October, in the month of October, like 15th October 2018. So earlier of these two dates would be 30th September 2018. So maximum time that is allowed to you for issuance of credit note is 30th September 2018. So in other words, the output tax liability, your output tax liability cannot be reduced. Why we are saying cannot be reduced? Because when you are issuing credit note to your customer, it means that your liability is getting reduced. So your output tax liability cannot be reduced in cases where credit note has been issued after September. Assuming that you have filed the annual return after the month of September 2018. In GST, only the supplier can issue debit or credit notes. The recipient cannot issue debit or credit notes. The format of credit note is similar to tax invoice format. Only four additional details are required to be mentioned. In the tax invoice format, we mention the invoice number, invoice date, right? So in the credit note, we have to mention credit note number and the credit note date. Along with this, we have to mention the original invoice date and original invoice number as well. So the details of original invoice against which you are issuing this credit note must also be mentioned. And those details are original invoice date and in original invoice number. Now, what are the contents of the credit note? Supplier details you have to give. You have, at the top, you have to mention that it is a credit note, serial number, date of issue of the document, that is credit note, serial number of the original invoice, date of issue of original invoice. If your recipient is registered, then name, address and GSTIN of the recipient. If your recipient is unregistered, the name, address and address of delivery along with the name of the state and its code. All these details are required if your recipient is unregistered. Taxable value of goods. This is fine. We are giving this in tax invoice also. Rate of tax is also fine. Signature. That's it. Thank you.